It's your Pharaoh Crimson of the Get It In Blood family. Download my new hit single, This Is For, and look for my latest album, Tulsa, to drop in the new year. Let's get it together. Let's get it in blood.
Right, they tryna move our dance. Aye. I got a bitch and a friend. After Aye. I fuck, they won't see me again. Aye. Movie, we laugh. AG pull up in the Benz. Louis put that on my lens. Aye. I ain't gon' touch it, she ain't a 10.
Cuida tu paso y no me pises payaso. Te va a ganar un fuletazo. Te voy borracho por lo que tengo en el vaso. Cuida tu paso y no me pises payaso. Te va a ganar un fuletazo.
I have a question. Do y'all gotta still, because the teachers where I live at, they still gotta show up to the school. Like,
nah,
they're in the class.
They tried to have us come for like a couple days, but then they couldn't logically explain why, because the cases were going up. Mm-hmm. So then they was like, okay, go home, teach from home. So we just be teaching from home.
Did y'all have any cases, though, in your school as far as teachers? After COVID?
Not in our school, but I teach in Pittsburgh Public, which is a big ass. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, like, other than Philly is the biggest, and then Pittsburgh Public. So there's cases, you know what I mean? Yeah. Not a lot. But they just, there was no rhyme or reason. You know what I mean? They all of a sudden they were like, oh no, teachers need to come back in the building. We're like, yo, the numbers is up. Like,
right.
You know, so you got to keep in mind too, when they make decisions like that, there's a union that goes through. So but yeah, we came in for fucking 3 days. What they want us to do eventually is both. I don't know how the fuck you do that. So you're going to have to virtually teach those who opt and have kids over here. Yeah. I don't know how the fuck you do that.
Wow.
That's not even reasonable to ask. I don't even know.
Right.
You have to do it like a Steve Jobs seminar, man, or some crazy shit like that.
I have a nephew in kindergarten and he does the virtual thing. Man. But like, how's that for you? Like, what are you telling them to like outline their letters and?
Well, nah, I teach gym, right? So I
teach. Right.
So that's even more. So we can do hit routines. I be looking up like YouTube hit routines, like the Black Panther hit routine. I'll play it. I'll just be like, get up. I'm like, turn your screens on right now, get up. Because some of them be in bed with their teddy bear. Yeah. So like, get up. So they get up, and then y'all be like, do whatever the person on the screen does, right? So it'd be like, you know, it'd be like someone dressed in a Black Panther suit, and they'll do like 30 seconds of an exercise, like the Wakanda punch. And it'll be like 10 seconds. Right? So I'm like, look, you're in front of, look, the tragedy is from, you're in front of your screen all day, and then a lot of times when school's over, you know, a lot of these parents are overwhelmed and doing so much. Yeah. They throw a movie on for the kid anyway.
Right,
so,
right.
Man, you are glued to this fucking
screen.
Sports are pretty much can't, like, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm like, get up, man. You know what I mean? We ain't going to, because I'm gym health, right?
Mm-hmm.
This food pyramid shit can wait. We'll talk about that down the road. Get up. You know what I mean?
Right. So, get that body active.
Yeah, like the regular subject teachers, I know, man, they be going through it, man. Because it's, you don't get that personal interaction, you know what I mean? And you could just see, like, it looks like the Brady Bunch screen, right?
Yeah.
You could just see kids fading, like and then the teacher will, not even falling asleep, just you could see their eyes, like they're lost. And the teacher will explain something and then come back to it and they still won't know.
Yeah, I was like that when I was in the class.
Yeah.
And shit. But my biggest thing is there's a lot of kids now who don't even have internet, let alone a computer in their motherfucking home and shit. Barely got a fucking fidget.
Well, they provide tablets. Yeah,
they provide tablets.
I mean, if you providing tablets and shit,
pay this
rent, motherfucker.
That became a shit show, too.
Pay this motherfucking rent. You got a we got a tablet, but we can't even fucking eat. We can't eat this shit.
But the travesty is this, too. Like, the what we use, right? We use this thing called Teams. And you, like, it's not Zoom, but it's like Zoom. But it'd be going down, it'd be glitching, it'd be fucking up. Mm. And then, you know what I mean? It'd be kicking kids out and all kinds of. The funny thing is, though, like, because everything is new, is an experiment kind of deal, right? So there's this thing called the mute button. So, like, kids be like unmuting, you can mute them. What, at the very beginning, the kids could do it too.
Right.
So, you be teaching, they just mute you and
mute
shit.
You, and you just say it works. And you just sit there.
And you don't know who it was, right?
Right.
You know, I mean, people need to stop. You're muted again. Like, stop muting. Like, it's real. Like, yeah. So,
that's
like, there's so many little, like, errors that go along with it, man. It's
what's the biggest misconception about public school, brother?
That the teachers don't care. Because these teachers be banging their head off the fucking wall. Not me. I mean, I care.
Right.
But listen, I got to maintain, like, you know, when I go home, I'm not, these teachers be taking this shit home with them, developing the most crazy, like, you know what I mean? There'll be parents going off on you and all kinds of shit. Like,
my daughter's going to go into teaching, and she's going to work with, I'm pretty sure, like, at-risk youth and special needs kids and things like that in schools. And I told her, like, that job comes with a lot of baggage. If you get too attached and bring your work home with you, it'll drive you crazy. Find some kind of zen place that you can find to separate your work from your everyday life. I know it's going to be hard, though.
And you got to give a kid a clean slate every day.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I had a kid slap me in the fucking face. Like, open palm, a fifth grader, smack, fire out me, man. Like, and I wasn't even like,
you weren't ready.
Listen, I wasn't ready. So the girl we had in the fifth grade was the bully. She was the meanest bully.
A girl at that.
It was a girl.
Mean, bro, mean. I loved her, but she was mean as fuck, right? And I would see little shit she did in the slide. So she did something mean to this kid. He started walking in front of the building. Once you leave my sight, I'm responsible. So I was going around. All I wanted to say was like, hey, man, I saw, but I kept a safe distance. I thought safe. This motherfucker stepped into it. I said, hey, listen, you're not in trouble. I just, man, he smacked my hat off and everything. I had a hat on him.
Hold on. And one slap.
Came from here. It was the angle was like this, but.
And he just.
Oh, that's that.
And
real
then
hit shit.
The, you caught the cheek and, look, and then took the hat off.
Boom, boom, boom. That's, hair disheveled and shit.
That's that Nipsey Hussle at the BET Awards smack. Google
that's
it.
This, yeah.
Nipsey Hussle at the BET Awards. It just came out of nowhere. He was mad calm. He was like, look, homie.
But the shit was October.
It was October.
It was like October. So I think he got like 3 days or something. I'm like, and I'm the gym. I get every kid in the building. As a gym teacher, you get, you know, the therapeutic kids or whatever. You get every fucking kid. So I'm like, I literally got to, because I'm kind of a grudge holder too, like naturally. Like, you know what I mean?
Hell yeah, you is. You got mad as fuck at me over your little comments on that back. Go ahead, bro. Talk your shit.
But look, so, you got to give him a clean slate, man. Mm. And some of the shit the kids be doing, man, you can't even, you know, you're like, why is he doing this?
So right? how did you handle it? Like,
I'm not going to front. Like, when he did it, I grabbed his arm.
And was like, yo.
Now, I grabbed his arm, and I started to walk him to the office. And I was like, man, if he swings on me again, man, like, I'm going to have to, like, defend myself. Right. You know what I mean? Like, I was so mad. My face was red. Like, I was fucking heated,
like,
man.
Damn,
but,
I'm
going
to have to drop kick this little kid.
He said, I'm going to have to defend myself.
Yeah, because I'm like... It was a very awkward, man. I've spoken to teachers that got their face spit in before.
Yeah, that's not, yeah.
And you gotta, and that's what I'm saying. So you gotta give a kid those are extremes, right?
Right.
But you'll get a kid a lot of times every fucking day shows up and is wilding out. And a lot of times out of frustration, and a lot of times it's just to impress people, whatever the case may be.
Right.
You gotta dedicate yourself every day to be like, all right. You know, I got to give them a clean slate the next day. Right. And it's a shame, like I said, subject teachers don't get to see, like, the fruits of their labor. So being a gym teacher, I seen the kindergarten that was wilding out, throwing stuff, and I see them by fifth grade kind of chill. And I'm like, damn, I wish their single grade teachers could see this progress. You know, but they get the next batch in.
These motherfuckers wanted that Beverly Hills 90210 shit and got East Side High with Joe Clark out this motherfucker. Rest in peace to the OG Joe Clark.
Right.
But yeah, man, you do noble motherfucking work, and I can only imagine, because there are a lot of misconceptions about public school all the time,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's hot for trap trapper turn smack rapper. Only smack rapper that you know is smack rappers. Got bars I can hang with the backpackers. Trap star, I don't hang with the backpackers. I'm in the hood with the work, you heard. Making fiends leave earth, you heard. Got your baby mama thirst, you heard. Feel the flow, nigga, throw it in reverse. This the wave you need to surf, you heard. Yo, Jim, I need a bomb I could drop on you niggas. Bad boy, I'm never gonna stop for you niggas. I don't give a fuck who you got as the illest. I solidify my spot with the realest. Now I'm rockin' you niggas.